entire way. Guide us through your Spirit. Help us to understand your good news and through your glory and I preach it in your name. Amen. Please be seated. I've been in talking a lot with different people about how I want to be like my heroes. But I'm not ready yet in some ways to do so. And one of my newest heroes now is Elizabeth Schuyler Hamilton. She was the wife of Alexander Hamilton, one of the forefathers of the nation. And that sounded like a lot of division going on in that time. And it kind of reflects some of the readings today. But one of the reasons that she's my hero is because she started out one way, and her life was a constant move forward, and she hung in there through thick and thin, through all the loss that she experienced and the realizations of the truth of her marriage that broke her heart. And she kept persevering. And she was confident in the faith of God. And we see in the second reading in Hebrews, which is often called the faith chapter, that it talks a lot about faith, but we're reminded of the various faith of the heroes in Scripture. Can anybody think of a hero in Scripture that through faith had it easy? That everything was smooth sailing. And they were completely filled with only blessing and no turmoil. I can't think of one person who walked in faith in God that wasn't confronted with a variety of difficulties in life. There are some named in Hebrews. Moses had to go through 40 years with a bunch of complaining Hebrews about everything. And there was challenges and there was stress. He was called to do God's work and in faith he did it. Ruth and Naomi. For Naomi, Naomi said, "My people will be your people, your people will be my people, and my God will be your God." And followed her. And there started part of the lineage of Jesus. Even in the new scriptures, think about Mary. I don't know how old she was. I think some say that she was 13. Pregnant, unwed. And in faith, she kept going forward. How is it that our faith is motivated? And what does our faith motivate? And what does faith do for us in this world? The readings today were very doom and gloom and judging. That's because judgment will be upon us. God does make judgment. God wants his world to be just and filled with peace, and he wants God wants all his poor people turn back to him and walk in his will. And that's why Jesus comes and says, "I didn't come here to bring peace." Mind you, I think he was under a lot of stress because he mentioned that. And so I think he was just getting tired of things. And he says, "I'm here to create division. People will be separated from one another." And I think that the reason is because when we follow the will of God, it sets us apart from what the status quo is. Because the will of God and love is the way you're supposed to journey. And those who do not follow the will of God are often those who live in opposition to God's grace, mercy, justice, and love. And when we walk in the path of love and do what is right, it does cause some division, right? How many people know that one know-it-all that always follows the rules and tells on you or tells you how to do the thing the right way? I know I'm that person. But why are you doing it that way? Why are you doing it that way? Shouldn't it be this way? You don't make a whole lot of friends by trying to do the right thing. It's not easy. And to do the right thing often takes you down paths you may not have ever been prepared for. What I found interesting in reading this book about Elizabeth Schuyler Hamilton, which is called My Dear Hamilton, totally recommend the book, it's awesome, is that I didn't realize the division that was caused back then, even. Because I'm from Canada, and in Canada, we have a lot of the same names of places that are here in the United States. And I can't imagine, because we had in my ancestry one person. Maybe I think his brothers went with them, I don't know. But they went to Canada to be loyal to the Queen while the rest of my family stayed here. So think about that. The founding of your country, the divisions that were caused based on federalism, Republican, British, or not, you know, it divided families. And I think in some ways Christianity does that for us too. Not that it divides families, but in this day and age, I don't know about you, but everybody has an opinion. And we struggle because a lot of the opinions out there have nothing to do with God's grace, mercy, justice, and love. And yet we want to defend them and stand strong in them at the peril of everything else. We are often dealt different things in life that make it hard. And then Paul in Hebrews talks about perseverance. Now, in my Jesus makes everything okay and peaceful mind, perseverance means just get to the end, right? You got it, get to the end. Then I looked up the definition, and I never really did that before, because we just know that the end is Jesus returning, right? But perseverance is the ability to run towards Jesus to all the goals Jesus has and enduring difficulty, enduring failure, oppression, or opposition. And all of us have different races that we run as Christians. Some had to struggle, locked up, put away until they were able to flee the captivity of the country they were in to come here. That's perseverance. God doesn't make things easy. God gives us the faith to motivate us to keep going. The hope we have in Christ, the example we have in Christ, the perfecter we have, it allows us to get rid of all the sin that has bound us, to live new lives focused completely on God, to continue to run the race. And it's different for everybody. I watched this one show a long time ago called It's a Bad Bill, but it was a really good show for metaphors and such. It's called Run Backward Run. And it was about a character who was running a race. He wanted to run a marathon because his girlfriend broke up with him, he lost his job, and he was miserable. He thought that he would run this marathon, impress his girlfriend, and get her back. Well, he was out of shape. And sometimes when we come to Jesus, we're out of shape. We're out of sorts. We're not really as developed as we need to be, but came to the race. He tried to train for it, drinking beer. You know, like, that's not the way to train for a race, but you know, he made our mistakes. But he finished the race. Well, after everybody else finished the race, but he finished the race. And it's kind of funny all the things that he endures as he's going through the race. He has various support from people around him. But then, like most marathoners know, you hit the wall. And if you ever hit a wall in any way, you're always like, I can't go on. I can't do this anymore. I need to quit. I need to stop. And I think that likened itself to a crisis of faith. Have you ever had that? Where you're like, I just can't do it anymore. If God, why is God making me do this? I can't go on. But when we hit that wall, it's the words that we hear in Scripture and the way in which the Holy Spirit guides us that we are able to pick ourselves up and break down that wall. Because Jesus gives us the helper to do that. I cannot tell you how many times I've had to pick myself up, wipe off the dust, and keep going. Perseverance, and I am friends right now. You know, it's difficult. But I know in the end where I'm being led. And what I'm called to do. And to speak where I need to speak. And to call out the injustice that God would Because that's what the heroes did. That's what Jesus did. And he's the biggest hero. And that brings me to the final point I want to make. Grace Church, and the members in this church, has persevered. Right? Has it been easy the past 10 years? There were lots of transitions, right? Some hurt, miscommunication, infighting, several different people coming in as leaders, feeling leaderless at times, never knowing when the process will end. And guess what? The people of this church kept their eyes focused on the perfecter of faith, continued to support the ministry of the church despite how they felt about what was going on, continued to keep the ministries afloat. And here we are. We go through a wall. I'm not saying I'm a chisel, but we go through a wall now. We have something permanent, and I hope it's good. time will tell. But we persevered that wall that we hit because of all of you and your willingness to walk in the Spirit. And now as we move forward, recognizing that divisions are going to happen because we're not all going to agree, how can we as a church body want to create the kingdom on earth and represent Jesus to the community? We're going to continue on the race. Let's do something together and celebrate the love of God and extend the grace, mercy, peace, and love that we have been granted to the world around us. To stand in opposition to anyone who says otherwise, but with grace, peace, and love, and mercy, and justice. Because to love Jesus isn't easy. To do what Jesus calls us to do isn't easy. But when we do it, Jesus for the better. Let's pray. Holy and gracious God, we thank you for all the ways in which you and your Spirit has strengthened us to persevere in our own individual races. And we also thank you for getting us through all those troubled times where we struggle. We thank you that we can work together in your Spirit to share your kingdom with the world around us. And we pray that you would inspire each of us to step up and step in.